Stadium in a salute to the class of 2021.
Xin kính chào quý vị. Hôm nay chúng tôi đang ở Học viện Hải quân của Hoa Kỳ. Hôm nay là ngày ra trường của những sinh viên ra 4 năm ở đây. Thì hôm nay chúng tôi có hân hạnh nói chuyện với cô Amy Hoàng, Amy Khanh Hoàng. Cô là hội trưởng của Hội Vietnamese Student Association. Đây là hội của người Việt gốc Mỹ, người Mỹ gốc Việt ở đây. Xin chào cô.
Xin chào quý vị. My name is Amy Khanh Hoàng from Plano, Texas. I'm a cyber operations major on the honors track, so I'll be graduating with honors, and I'm the president of the Vietnamese Student Association.
Can you tell us how many Vietnamese Americans are enrolled in the U.S. at the U.S. Naval Academy for this time, and how many are graduating in this class of 2021?
So at the Naval Academy as a whole, about 2% of the Naval Academy is Asian, of Asian descent. And in terms of Vietnamese, we make up a small percentage of that small percentage. So in our club, in the Vietnamese Student Association Club, we have about 250 members. Not all of them are full Vietnamese descendant, but and some of them aren't Vietnamese at all, but they enjoy the Vietnamese culture. So we have about 200 in our Vietnamese Student Association Club right now. Now the graduating class, we have about 20 Vietnamese students that are of Vietnamese heritage.
Why is the Vietnamese Student Association at the Naval Academy so important?
It's so important because the Navy celebrates diversity. Diversity is a huge part of what makes our American military and American Navy strong as a whole, with our diversified thinking. So we really celebrate diversity. We really celebrate different heritage, different cultures here. For example, the month of May is dedicated to the Asian Pacific Islander Heritage Month. So Vietnamese Student Association is really important to me personally, not only because I'm Vietnamese, a Vietnamese descendant, and I was born and raised with the culture, but also to give other Vietnamese students and other people who love and celebrate the culture of the Vietnamese heritage a place where they can celebrate that together and really celebrate Vietnamese culture together. And Ipa, we all love to ăn phở.
Amy, can you tell us the challenges of a midshipman at the U.S. Naval Academy, and what subjects are the most challenging? And after graduation, what are the challenges ahead for our graduates as a unsigned, or for the Marine Corps as a second lieutenant?
Yeah, I think the most challenging thing for all the midshipmen is definitely the time commitment here, the rigors. Like, it's very challenging. Our schedule is very regimented, and we have to pass a physical test every semester, as well as academics. We have to pass academically. The courses are very rigorous here, but it's very challenging, but it's very rewarding. So,
of the Vietnamese student graduates, Vietnamese American student graduates today, what's the percentage of female versus the total graduates?
Yeah. So here we hold about 25%. 25% are female, and the rest 75% are male.
Okay, and what is the most subject that people study at the academy?
Yeah, so most people study economics here, economics or political science. My major is cyber operations with honors, so that's the third largest major currently here. Pretty popular.
Have you been assigned to a unit here, or is it local? Or
oh, yeah. So in November, we all found out what jobs we're going to do after the Naval Academy, and so I'll be doing a surface warfare officer on the nuclear track. So I'll be a SWO nuke, and I'll be based out of Yokosuka, Japan next year.
We're so proud of the Vietnamese American service men and women in the U.S. Armed Services. We currently actually have five Vietnamese American generals and admiral. And are you familiar with them?
Oh, yes. We actually, as president of the Vietnamese Student Association, we invited Rear Admiral Huynh Thi Nguyen down to the Naval Academy just 2 weekends ago. He came down and spoke to us. He ate pho with us, actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so he came and talked to all the Vietnamese Student Association members here.
What do you recommend for Vietnamese Americans wanting to attend the academy, or in general, like West Point or the armed services in the U.S.?
Yeah. I say go for it. It's such an incredible opportunity here to serve our country. Both my parents immigrated from Vietnam, and so it was a really great way to give back to a country that accepted my parents. And I was born and raised here in Plano, Texas. Now I'm about to serve my country so proudly. And I'd say just volunteer a lot, leadership opportunities, and just apply for the Naval Academy, because you never know if you'll, it's a great opportunity.
So you could be president one day?
Maybe. The options are limitless here. You could do, we've graduated many, many successful people, whether in the civilian business, whether in the military.
So you plan to make this a long career for you?
I haven't decided yet. Wherever the wind blows.
Are there members of your family, like your parents, your grandparents, serving in the Republic of Vietnam in the past?
Yeah. Yes, my grandpa served in the Vietnamese Army, as well as my uncle on my dad's side, Chu Thuan, is also a captain in the American Navy right now. He's doing really well. And my great uncle has also served in the Vietnamese Army as well.
So. And do you have any siblings wanting or currently are in the service?
I have two younger brothers, so they're both falling behind me. One of them, my middle one, he's actually a freshman in college. He'll be doing ROTC at UNT, hopefully going to Air Force after the Air Force ROTC.
I'm glad to hear that he has aspirations for the service for the US of A. And we thank you so much for your time. And again, congratulations, and wish you well in your new assignment in November.
Thank you.
Cũng nên biết thêm đó, có nhiều người nổi tiếng đã ra trường tốt nghiệp ở trường Hải quân Mỹ này, là ông Tổng thống Jimmy Carter, ông nghị sĩ Jim Webb, và cũng nhiều người rất là có trong chính phủ cũng đã ra trường từ đây. Thì trong những người mà làm tư lệnh hải quân đó thì có ông đô đốc Admiral Zumwalt, thì ông cũng ra trường ở trường hải quân Hoa Kỳ này khóa 1941. Thì cái trường hải quân này nó đào tạo ra những cái người thủy quân lục chiến, tại vì thủy quân lục chiến là một phần trong hải quân của Hoa Kỳ. Thành ra hai cái quân chủng này nó dính liền với nhau. Ngoài ra, ngoài những cái sinh viên mà từ nước Mỹ thì cũng có nhiều cái sinh viên được gửi từ những cái nước trên thế giới, những cái nước bên Âu Châu, Á Châu, cũng có Việt Nam được gửi qua đây huấn luyện ở trường hải quân này. Hôm nay là cái ngày lễ ra trường, thì cái ngày hôm nay là cái ngày được gắn lon thiếu quý cho tất cả những sinh viên, thì cái ngày này cũng là một cái ngày bổ nhiệm cái công sở mới của những người sinh viên này. Thì trong cái công sở mà được bổ nhiệm, nó có thể về những cái môn chuyên môn học, thì cũng có về y khoa, về luật, về chỉ huy. Thành ra người ta được tuyển những cái khóa sinh này đi thẳng về đơn vị phục vụ của mình trong quân đội Hoa Kỳ.
Class of 2021, please rise. I propose three cheers for those we leave behind. Hip hip. Hip hip.